So here we are then, welcoming you today to one of the jewels of the Arab world, Jeddah, one of the biggest cities in Saudi Arabia, second only to Riyadh, gateway to Mecca, and one of the biggest ports in the region. And now, host to the Saudi Arabia Grand Prix. So let's take a look at the topographical map of the Jeddah street circuit. As you can see, a number of challenging corners for the drivers to master here. We'll see just how much the teams have benefited from their time spent in practice this weekend. And like many street circuits, this track has the potential to punish drivers that get it wrong. Let's hope we avoid any safety cars today. Before we begin, let's take a quick look at the grid lineup for today's race. Stevens lines up on pole position, and a very happy Carlos Sainz will start second. As we continue through the rest of the grid today, we have Magnussen, Norris, Max Verstappen, and Leclerc, Gasly, Theo Pourchaire, Oscar Piastri, and Alex Albon, Drugovic, Bottas, Daniel, Anthony Davidson joins me once again.
After the points finished last race, let's aim to keep that momentum going.
Second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone.
corners, the stewards are going to give you a penalty. Be careful. Okay, we've been given a time penalty. It will go against our finishing time at the end of the race. Get your head down and let's get it done.
Drive that was to take the win for Ferrari today. Anthony, tell me, what was it that helped them achieve this success?
Well, I honestly feel it was down to the driver and car today. I mean, we can talk driver skill all day, but if you don't have a solid team to back that, you're never going to get anywhere. When you hit that sweet spot of having both an excellent driver and an incredible car, that's when you see results like those we witnessed today.
And here we are, a team that is no stranger to the podium, taking their place on top once again. A sublime race today, and a stunning win for Ferrari. So let's see what effect this result has had on the driver's standings. Stevens increases their championship lead.
We need your input here. Not an easy choice, I know. Thanks for stepping in and helping handle that. Okay, we've had the new parts come through the fabrication process. We'll have them with us for the next Grand Prix. Our new parts have completed without issue. They'll be on the car ready for the next race weekend.
flat. We're very pleased with that.
And with qualifying complete, let's review our top three today. Stevens, Verstappen... Hello and welcome from Melbourne, a track modified since we last raced here in Albert Park. And I think with the changes, it's going to be a classic. The Melbourne circuit is certainly one that needs to be taken seriously. It's a combination of slippery surfaces and difficult corners, making it a very tricky track when it comes to overtaking. Drivers find it hard to pass and will need to take full advantage of those DRS zones if they want to have any hope of breaking through. Off the back of a fantastic qualifying session, it's time to see how our starting grid looks like for today's race. Stevens lines up on pole position, and Max Verstappen lines up alongside. Considering the rest of the grid, we have Sainz, Norris, Kevin Magnussen, and Oscar Piastri. Theo Pourchaire, Leclerc, Ricciardo, and Pierre Gasly. Drugovich, Bottas, Daniel Tictum, and Tsunoda. Liam Lawson, Albon, Guan Yu Zhou, and Esteban Ocon. Schwartzman, and Nicholas Latifi. It's almost time for those five...
Okay, now that we've got some good points on the board, let's continue this form and aim for another top 10 finish. be enabled this lap. You can use it when you're within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone.
Some great battles on the streets of Melbourne today then, and they've taken a fantastic win. Natalie Pinkham, how do you think they were able to set themselves apart today?
Well, they certainly stood out as a driver with tons of confidence on the track. I think their ability to keep their cool, even during some of the more hectic parts of the race, meant they were able to capitalise on the mistakes of other drivers, giving them the opportunity to make their way to the top spot with ease.
Here come our winners now. A thrilling race and a tremendous effort by Ferrari. Their history is well known, so it's no surprise to fans the world over to see them come out on top once again. So then, it's time to see how this result affects the Drivers' Championship. Stevens increases their championship lead. So then, Natalie Pinkham, who would you rank as your driver of the day?
Well, it's absolutely got to be Alexander Albon. No hesitation. He put in a performance today that's only going to build further.
OK, we've had the new parts come through the fabrication process. We'll have them with us for the next Grand Prix. Could you take a look at this for us, please? Thanks for handling that.
Ready for tomorrow's race, but before we begin, let's have a...
This is the team's home race. We're all relying on you to impress today.
Thank you.
job, mate. Really well done. That was a fantastic drive.
And now let's take a look at the driver standings. Stevens increases their championship lead. Welcome once again to the Autodromo Internazionale Enzo Edino Ferrari. The clue's in the name. This is very much Ferrari home turf, and the locals will be out in force today to support their team in what we hope will be a magnificent spectacle of motorsport. So with the race not far away from starting, here's what today's grid run. Anthony Davidson.
After the points finished last race, let's aim to keep that momentum going. final lap. Final lap of the race. Well done.
And that's it then for the Emilia-Romagna Grand Prix. And what a sensational victory they've managed to pull off here. And talk to me, what do you think it was that sealed the win for them?
I think that smart tyre management on track and very smooth driving definitely assisted in their victory today. That combination meant they got the absolute maximum out of their tyres at all times.
Looking at the podium, you can see that red suit familiar to fans across the globe. A world-class win for a world-class team. Ferrari, do it again. After this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the drivers' table. Stevens.
Our new parts have completed without issue. They'll be on the car ready for the next race weekend.
good job, mate. Really well done. That was a fantastic drive.
With qualifying finished, it's time to remind us. We're here in the coastal shores of Florida for the Miami Grand Prix, which has become the 11th Formula One track held in the United States. The grandstands are packed for what we hope is going to be another fantastic race. Sitting at the southeastern coast of Florida, the Miami International Autodrome has 19 corners and 3.36 miles of racing. It's a circuit designed to encourage close racing while meeting the highest safety standards. Either way, I'm sure it's one that will please the fans. Let's run you through the driver grid order for today's exciting race. Stevens lines up on pole position, and Lando Norris lines up alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Teo Pourchaire, Verstappen, Kevin Magnussen, and Sainz, Albon, Ricciardo, Leclerc and Oscar Piastri, Gasly, Drugovich, Valtteri Bottas and Tictum, Liam Lawson, Tsunoda, Robert Schwartzman and Esteban Ocon, Latifi and Guan Yu Zhou. It's almost time for the lights to go out, so let's head down to the track where preparations are underway. With the Grand Prix nearly upon us, Anthony Davidson is by my side once again to offer his perspective. Let's talk about Stevens. That was a great win in the last race, but can they keep that momentum going into this weekend?
There are never any guarantees in this business, but certainly the performance last time out would have boosted their confidence coming into this one.
Okay, now that we've got some good points on the board, let's continue this form and aim for another top 10 finish.